Welcome back, everybody, to another episode of the Freeschoolin' Homestead. We're a little place here in near Barrie, Ontario. My name is Wendy, and today I am going to perform attempt number two at the farmer's market and hope that my camera doesn't die. So I'm just about to go onto the highway, and then I'm going to go ahead and turn it back on when I get off the highway because I don't want to talk while I'm driving for safety reasons until I get used to this. So come along with me as I go to the farmer's market. Take two. Alright, we're off the highway. Now on the way. It's a really beautiful day out, so I figured I would give you guys a view of what I'm seeing here. I'm not sure if the clouds are coming in or going out, but it's really beautiful either way. Oh, there's someone with a tricycle. It's actually awesome. Oh, never mind. That's a really cool little thing they had there. Anyway, so my plan is to get kale, eggs, chicken. They have organic bacon there. I'm going to get syrup. I need a big bottle of syrup because we usually get one of those a month to try and supplement for sugar. Even though we do use organic sugar, we would rather use all natural syrup because it actually has a lot of nutrients in it. I think that's all. Oh, I think I need some, also some ground beef and apples. I'm gonna see what they have in the produce. I'm kind of excited because when I came here last week, my camera died, but I was really nervous. I didn't know how it would be. So now I kind of know what I'm doing, so it's pretty easy. I'm feeling just like it's a sunny day. I'm just gonna go get some local groceries. I'm feeling really good about the purchase too, because instead of worrying about what it will be like socially, I'm thinking how great it is that we now are sourcing our food locally, which is something it's really I've wanted to do for a long time. And my husband and I, Jay's, and I were talking this morning about how we probably could have done this a long time ago. But it was really our priority shifts that allowed this, not money. We actually lost our truck in the middle of all this, so there's no really real excuse we have now to have not done this before. But at least I now know I can be fooled by perception, and I want to make sure I'm always looking for that. That there is no reason we had to wait for so long. We could have been doing this all along. So every time I think I can't afford something, whether it's time or money, I think, how can I readjust my priorities rather than get more of the resource that I think I need? Because it's the freest way to do, and it's easy. It's really easy because you're just shifting priority. Sorry about getting cut off there. So yeah, so I'm really glad that we learned how to find a way to do this without needing more money, because it's not something we have. Oh, sorry, there's a lot of noise. It's not something we have a lot of money, at least not now. We do have a book for sale, so please see the description down below for our book, speaking of money. But we do not really get an income from that per se. It's just more of a venture that we're doing, and a desire that, you know, we were really inspired to do it because of our lifestyle. So yes, so I'm gonna go there. I'm gonna get everything I need to get. I'm not gonna be filming inside again, but I will show you everything that I bought. And if I decide, I actually have to go pick up some batteries too. So if I go there, maybe I'll feel brave enough to, I'm not even sure where I'm gonna pick them up. So I guess I'll kind of bring you along that as I go. So, to the farmer's market! Okay, so this is an amazing view of the power lines of Barrie, Ontario. Okay, no, just because there's like a lot going on around here and I don't want to inadvertently film people and then them get mad at me, so. And I have to do it in my truck because there's people everywhere and I'm way too anxious to talk in front of them. It's crazy in there. I got everything I needed. I'm gonna show you guys when I get home all the stuff that I got. I spent $75 and I got all of our meat for the month. And our week's worth of produce. And I also got one thing of eggs. So, but because we have like 4 dozen at home, I can't believe how stocked up we are. And I can't believe, you know, this has got me thinking about the look on the lady's face when I paid for the meat. She recognized me from last week. And you know, that's because nobody spends that much money. And I only spent like $40 on meat. We know we go to the grocery store and we spend more than that. So this is like my big plug for not the Barrie Farmers Market specifically, but any farmers market where you feel like you can get good quality ingredients or food. It's so amazing to know that you're making an impact with like $60. So in 2 weeks, was it 2 weeks? Yeah, 2 weeks I spent $100. And that's literally all that we need, and that's more than just meat. That's all that we need for the month in meat. It's more than that. It's like 2 months of meat, honestly, because we still have the stuff that we bought last month. So we are saving. We have more than we could possibly use, and we're buying locally, and it's all organic. I can't think of a better way to do this. So really, there's my plug. Buy from the farm, buy locally, buy all natural. I mean, actually all natural and all organic, the definition of it, not just the label. Because not everybody tells the truth. So it's great to know where your food is coming from. I know that I could drive within, you know, 20 minutes to a half an hour to where my meat was being raised. That's amazing. And I know the people that are making it, that they're feeding the quality food that they need to eat instead of the crap just to get them to go bigger faster. I feel like a weight has been lifted off. So that, I would recommend that just for peace of mind. If that's something you're interested in, you know, trying to save money, trying to, you know, go, how do I do it all? Go to your farmer's market. It's like a double or triple whammy as far as its solution for a bunch of problems. So I am going to go off, I think, probably to Walmart. I know, boo. But I don't know where else to get batteries right now, and I really want batteries for my CD player. I know, what am I, in the 90s? Yeah, well, I'm 41, so that makes sense. So I need batteries for my CD player that I'm going to, I like to go out in the barn and just chill out and just listen to music, which River doesn't really like right now because he's probably like listened to a lot of music in barns and it's not as pleasant. But I'm actually doing some interpretive dance with him. So I just need to get him used to the music, and I also need music out there, and we have no electricity. So batteries it is, so we can get like a really long extension cord. So if you've seen any of our other videos, it's quite a hike from our house to the barn. And again, there's no water or power back up there. So yeah, I'm gonna go and pick up those batteries, and then I'm gonna probably film all of what I bought and show you so you can see what $75 worth of groceries at the farmer's market in Barrie, Ontario will buy you. So yeah, I'm gonna go.
okay, I'm home. I didn't end up getting batteries because I didn't know if I needed C4s or C8s, so yeah. I got some underwear and socks for Hope because she really needed them. But on to my haul. So this is the organic farmer's market haul. I got this area here, so the meat and eggs, was $60, and this will last us like a month easy. I think they're all organic, they're all grass-fed or organic feed-fed. That was 60. So we've got chicken, frozen half chickens, a dozen eggs, 2 pounds of bacon. That's not 2 pounds, I don't even know what it is. Sorry, you can't see that. I'll look later. So that we don't have to watch my awful camera work. So I got two packages of bacon and 2 packages of, oh, they're all frozen by the way, ground beef. What I just do is I'll cook it up and then I can freeze it again. We feed the dog. Once a week we do a pound of ground beef. That's a new thing we've been doing for the dog. So that's really good. So yeah, $60 for our month's supply of meat. It's awesome. And then we have this cost $15. So we got head of organic broccoli, organic kale, celery, organic of course, and some Fuji apples, $15. So there's your $75 organic farmer's market haul. That was crazy, and I'm kind of glad I'm home, so I'm gonna go and relax. Thanks so much for watching. Like, share, subscribe. Much love from the Freeschoolin homestead.